What did you come to do, Sister Tana? Huh? Praise the Lord. glory. You are a chef, a true light, a true God. You are King of Kings and you're Lord of Lords. You are King of Kings. You created heaven and earth. We are made in your image today. We want to be more and more like you, Heavenly Father. Heavenly Father, we want to greet you on today. Huh? We want to magnify you on today, Heavenly Father. Because you've done so much for us. You woke us up this morning. Hallelujah. Clothed in our right mind with the activities of our being. But he didn't have to do it. But he did. He didn't have to do it. He didn't have to wake you up this morning. Hallelujah. But he woke you up. Come on, say it. He woke you up.
Woke you up.
Moving.
Yeah.
With your well-being. Hallelujah. We thank you, Lord God. We thank you for your many blessings. We asking you, Heavenly Father, for your blessings. We asking you for healing. We asking you to save our souls. We asking you to save our family. We asking you to save our friends. In Jesus' name. Say in Jesus' name.
you told us not to do, but the Lord, you picked us up. And so this day, we are here. Scripture for 2023 is Proverbs 18:21. Death and life is in the power of the tongue, and they that love it shall eat the fruit thereof. Come on, let's thank God for our praise team today. Wow. Let's thank God for Minister Nora and Minister John Thomas back in the band pit again. Wow. What a refreshing. What a blessing. Thank God for them. I see Brother Dye here up and grab his bundles. Just like ain't nothing changed. Ain't nothing changed. Come on, let's thank God for our First Lady. Ah, yes. What a blessing. Any visitors? Anybody here first time? Just stand up today. That's all we're going to do is celebrate you. Come on, let's thank God. Let's thank God. Let's thank God. Thank God for you. Thank God for you. You are welcome. Everybody, everybody. God bless you. You may be seated. In 23, we have what we say. Amen. Any day of the week, any day, any time, what we say. Somebody say, I'm more blessed today,
I'm more blessed today
than yesterday.
Yes.
Somebody say, I got more blessings coming in 23. More blessings. Right now, even now, more blessings. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody say, I have the best. Not what's left. I have the best. If they. Amen. Okay. Now, let's pull up our first scripture for the day. And this is the tradition Sunday before crucifixion. This is Palm Sunday. Amen?
Amen.
Palm Sunday was that Jesus came riding into the city upon the donkey. Amen? And when he rode in upon the donkey, amen. Y'all, when he get it up, I want y'all to read. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Everybody read.
And when he was come nigh, even now at the descent of the Mount of Olives, the whole multitude of the disciples began to rejoice and praise God with a loud voice for all the mighty works that they had seen.
Come on. Amen. Say, blessed be the King that cometh in the name of the Lord. Peace in heaven and glory in the highest. Check this next one out. What does it say?
Some of the Pharisees from among the multitude said unto him, Master, rebuke thy disciples.
Hold up. Don't y'all miss this. People were rejoicing that Jesus had entered in, and it was the bishop and the apostle and the elder and the pastor. It was the leadership. The Pharisees were the leadership. And they told Jesus to rebuke his disciples. Tell them, stop praising you. Did you hear what I just said?
Yes.
They that were the leadership told Jesus, rebuke your disciples and tell them to stop praising you. Somebody say,
don't let
religious leaders make you stop praising Jesus. Come on in this place. Don't let religious leaders, don't let religious folks, church folks, tell you to shut up. He said, tell them to shut up. Stop praising you. Come on, look what it said. Come on. Everybody read.
And he answered and said unto him, I tell you that if these should hold their peace, the stone would immediately cry out. My God.
What did Jesus say? If these will stop, I'll raise up some stones. If I can make a donkey talk, I can make a rock talk. But I'm going to get some praise from somebody. Now pull up our subject for the day. Pull up our subject for the day. Hallelujah. Everybody read what it said.
Give God the praise. He's done.
Come on, shout in this place. Come on. You praise God for what he's done for you. You praise God for what he's done for you. You praise God for what he's done for you. Don't let no rocks cry out for you. Don't let no religious folks cry out and tell you to shut up. What God has done for you, don't you let nobody shut your mouth. You praise God for what he's done for you. Come on, tell your neighbor, you don't know. Like I know what he's done for me. Okay, this is what we're going to do now. I want you that want to say just one thing that the Lord done for you. Y'all pay attention to me. I don't want you to tell all of it. I want you to tell one thing that the Lord did for you. You line it up in the middle aisle.
Hallelujah.
If you want to tell one thing that the Lord done for you today, line up in the middle aisle.
I'm sure I'm going to line up.
Just one thing.
I guess you got to line up. Amen.
I want them faces all these. Because they can't. One thing.
Just one thing.
What if I got a lot?
The subject is, I'm going to praise God for what he's done for me.
Amen.
Ain't too many times the preacher stop preaching so you can testify of what the Lord have done for you.
Hallelujah.
And y'all obedient.
I am obedient.
That means you're going to tell one thing. And then you're going to take your seat. Come on, teacher. She's going to start us off right.
God, deliver me from a spirit of jealousy.
Hallelujah. Come on, deacon. God made me here for a purpose.
God kept me.
He saved my life.
Go down another aisle for me. Sister, go down the aisle that way. Yes, come on. Yeah.
Woke me up this morning.
God took me out of the streets of hell. The Lord delivered me from myself. He saved my life and saved my soul. I know God to be faithful to his word.
He made his word real.
You know, I don't know how you marrow it down to one thing. There's so many things God has done.
That's
for us.
Right.
But he brought me and this gentleman out of the hospital with COVID.
I don't know what God has done for you, but he brought me a mighty long way.
Morning, church.
Good morning.
God has been so good to me in spite of everything I've been through. I've been through so much, but I'm still standing tall. I want to thank God for blessing me with my breath. All the time.
Hallelujah. She said, thank God for blessing her with her breath. Come on now.
God did everything for me. I need to go up. That God put my clothes on for me this morning.
Put clothes on him this morning.
He helped me. God helped me with my homework.
Saved my life. God gave me a brand new bathroom downstairs.
God gave me joy. Hallelujah.
God saved me. I'm happy for the strength.
God
God bless me with a job.
Hallelujah. Thank God for the job. Come on, brother.
God woke me up this morning.
Yeah. Come on, mama.
And God woke me up from a coma.
Bring the mic up a little bit, just a little bit. There you go. Now.
And God woke me up from a coma.
Yes.
I was asleep for 2 days. And I know He did it just so I could worship Him much longer.
Yeah. Come on, God woke me up from a coma. I've been testifying to that. Yeah. God woke me up from a coma. God gave me this
beautiful life.
God gave me a beautiful life. Yes.
God gave me happiness.
God gave
me
happiness. Come on.
God kept me in His path.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God kept me in His path.
God gave me peace in my life and in my soul.
God gave us peace in the life and the soul. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I'm celebrating 7 years. From a brain tumor.
Come on now.
And I thank God He gave me life.
7 years from a brain tumor. Come on here. Hallelujah.
I would like to say, He brought me and my wife to church this morning.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
Many things in my life are healed me from the COVID-19.
Hallelujah.
That brought me here a long time ago.
Yes.
I'm here.
Yes. Yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, she said, God brought her here a long time ago. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Just take it out.
Take the microphone.
Not you, your husband.
Que
va
que
se
el
micrófono dice
que está escuchando
lo de acá.
Your husband. Hello, church. Hello. You would have to experience what I'm going through to know that God is faithful and true.
Yeah. God is faithful and true. Hallelujah.
Like Randy said, it's hard to just pick one thing, but
yes.
I want to thank you for saving me,
woo!
For getting me through the passing of my husband,
yeah.
And the fact that I'll see him one day.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
God gave me a job so I can pay more tax.
Hallelujah. I'm going to shout with you like
this. Hey,
God woke me up this morning.
God woke her up this morning. Yes.
Y'all turn around here.
God helped me get up this morning.
God helped you to get up this morning. Come on, He sure did.
God gives me peace and gives me the ability to love.
Come on.
Come on, peace and the ability to love. Praise the Lord.
I still thank God for saving me from drugs and alcohol.
Yeah, come on, thank God. Hallelujah.
God bless me with my first job.
Yeah. Woo. Come on, Joy.
God delivered me from a cyst on my kidney, a cyst on my liver, and the doctor said, I'll see you in 8 years. No cancer.
Hallelujah. No cancer. Come on.
God saved me for 13 years. I had a beating on the brain.
Uh-huh.
And He saved my daughter.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus. Come on. God saved her from an aneurysm and saved her daughter from sickness. Come on.
There's no one thing to thank God for. God is everything.
Yes.
Everything. God did everything.
Everything.
My blessing, because
my brain got built up so much of the Holy Spirit. And that's because I kept going. I wasn't going to church until my wife started coming here. Then I started coming.
Thank you, Jesus.
Man, to be for that, I don't know what I would be like right now. But if we didn't have the kind of minister that we got, some of us wouldn't even be still here. We're going to stay here.
God healed my body.
Yes. Come on, give God praise for healing her body.
God in this.
Amen. God is catching her. Praise the Lord. Amen.
You got nothing to say, Adrian? Yeah, I did do that.
Yes.
God's in us. Okay.
He turned the mass in my breast to benign.
Yeah. Come on. Hallelujah. Everybody get on your feet all over the building. Come on, somebody say, you don't know like I know. Okay, yeah, that's a song. Y'all thought I was talking, I was singing. You don't know like I know. 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 I get joy when I think about.
What he's done for me.
I don't know about you, but ain't no rocks gonna cry out for me. No religious person gonna shut me down. If I got to move away from you, because in my excitement, I might hit you. I mean, hallelujah. Somebody said, he's been too good for me to shut my mouth. And I don't care what devil in hell that might not like it, but the Lord has been so good. I got to shout. I got to raise my voice. I got to dance. I got to clap my hands. Okay, let me help some of y'all. How many want some more blessings? I know you do. You're just like me. You're greedy. You just... Okay, I'm going to tell you how to get them. God inhabits the praises of his people. So God said, when I hear you praising me, I'm coming where you are so I can get you what you praising me for and get you more of what you need. So when you praise God, God said, now I'm obligated to get to you. We gotta go. Have a seat. Deep, you might want to turn the heat down. I think we can heat it up. It ain't for nobody but me. Glory to God. I'm going to praise God, Jesus, for what he's done for me. And you don't know, like I know, what he's done for me. So when you don't understand my praise, I understand why. But even though you don't understand, and you may look at me funny, I know what he's done for me. And so what he's done for me, I get joy. When I think about it, is it my right name? When I think about the goodness of the Lord and all that he's done for me, my soul cries, hallelujah! See, the problem ain't enough praise. Y'all know the world is full of murmuring and complaining. All right, I don't want y'all to get mad, but lots of Christians talk about the devil more than they talk about Jesus. Uh-oh. The devil do what it is, I'm going to praise him. You're going to praise him for what he's done for you.
Oh, yes, God.
You know, the Lord was telling me, he said, there's so many testimonies in this church, it don't make any reason for us to be sitting looking like we look a lot of days. Because what happens, we have a tendency to forget what he done and think about what he ain't done yet. And so we don't praise him for what he's done, so we cut ourselves short of what he wants to do. And if you want more, then you'll learn how to praise him for what he's done. Okay, I'm going to just do this. Anybody ever been in a car wreck? Lift your hand.
I have.
Look around you.
And I walked away.
Look around you, all these hands. Every Sunday we ought to be in here shouting and dancing just because you made it to a car wreck. Is there anybody been in a wreck?
Yeah.
Hands went up all over this place. Okay, anybody ever been sick?
Yes.
And got well?
Hallelujah.
Ooh, look at the hands. Come on, somebody help me preach. It's shame on you if you don't praise the Lord for making you well, healing you from COVID, healing you from the flu, healing you from all other kinds of attacks. Anybody have surgery? Anybody been under the knife? Look at you. Look at us. Down. No, hard. Get down on them high keys. Get out of that bass. Get down on that other end.
Hey.
I want you to come back next Sunday. I'm just messing with you a little bit. But Minister Nora, in my head, I hear the high sound. Okay. I know you just got back. Here I am already started over just like I did before. What about that Hammond? Can you try that now?
Okay.
Let me leave the musician alone. Y'all said leave him alone. We just got him back. Here you go. You asking people back in that booth. I've been back there supervising and directing since I got out here 12 o'clock. They looking at me like, really? Here you go again. I don't mean no harm. But I have stuff going on in my head. Like, Brother C.L., my brain. Where's he at? Oh, he's back there. Somebody said, I'm going to praise God for what he's done for me. Does that seem like you got that right to praise him for what he's done for you? So if what God done for me, just maybe he didn't do for you, I'm sorry, but I got to praise him for what he done for me. So you may not understand my praise. You may not understand my tears. You may not understand why I wave my hand. You may not understand why I take off and run sometimes. You may not understand that I. But when I think of the goodness of Jesus and all he's done for me, my soul. Somebody say my emotions, my feelings. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Yeah. So let's go to the next scripture. Why, Minister Noah, all I want to do is just hit a couple chords on that Hammond. I know y'all talk to me after service. Tell me. We were doing good till you went to. Look, give me the next scripture.
Yeah.
Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Oh, it wasn't plugged in either. Oh, Lord Jesus. Read, big board. Let's see what it say. And he led them forth by the right way that they might go to the city of habitation. And oh, that men would what?
Praise the Lord.
Oh, that men would do what?
Praise the Lord.
And then it says what?
For his good.
Is God done anything good that you ought to praise him?
Yes.
David is telling us if we just praise him for his goodness. I heard somebody say he woke me up this morning. It don't get no better than that because somebody didn't wake up. Come on. He started us on our way. Come on here. He put clapping in our hands. Put patting in our feet. Yeah, there you go. Saturday morning was go to the blinds and look and see if the old shed was still standing, and the old door falls down and the old door was still standing up. I said, hallelujah. See, you don't know like I know that I got a raggedy shed. And first lady said, you type why go buy a new shed, all right? I'm gonna put that door back up again. Keep my kibbles in bed. Somebody said, what's good to me may not be good to you. My situation may not be your situation, but I want God to recognize, oh God, I appreciate you being good to me.
Thank you, Lord.
Read, everybody. He said, for he satisfieth the longing soul and filleth the hungry soul with what? Now, y'all remember now, we got to get down the road.
Jesus.
But I'm going to need y'all to use your imagination with me now. I had you coming up.
Yes.
Giving a little bit of your testimony. Yes. Now I need you to, in your mind, begin to do some imagination with me. Okay?
Come on.
The Bible said, multitudes met him when he entered into the city. And they kept saying, Hosanna! Hosanna! Blessed is he! That cometh in the name of the Lord. Let's do a little bit of imagining who was in the multitude.
Come on now.
Come on.
Let's just imagine there was two blind men that sat by the road one day, and they heard that Jesus was passing by, and they began to cry out, Hosanna! Hosanna, Jesus, have mercy on me. And I can imagine that that day when Jesus entered in, that the two blind men, the two blind men wasn't blind no more. And they was in the multitude. And they were hollering, Hosanna! Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Can you imagine in the multitude there was that woman that had the issue of blood, and she had went to the doctors and spent all her money, but she heard that Jesus was coming through the city, and she got down on her knees and she crawled over and she touched the hem of his garment. Her blood issue dried up. Can you imagine in the multitude that woman who'd been healed from the blood issue was in the crowd hollering, Hosanna! Blessed is he that comes in the name of the Lord. Can you imagine the woman who was the mother-in-law of Peter? She was sick. And Jesus came over to the house and touched her hand, and she rose up and went to cooking. Can you imagine that lady that was sick was in the multitude hollering, Hosanna, Hosanna, blessed is he that comes in the name of the Lord. Can you imagine there was a man who was a centurion, and he had a sick servant that was at home, and my God, he came to Jesus. He said, Jesus, you a man of authority, and I'm a man of authority. And Jesus said, I'll come to your house. But Jesus said, all you got to do, the man said to Jesus, all you got to do is speak the word, and my servant will be made whole. Can you imagine that in that multitude, that centurion and his servant were hollering, Hosanna, Hosanna, blessed be the name of the Lord. Can I give you one more? Can you imagine a Mary Magdalene? She had a bad reputation. She was a street walker, but Jesus, he came to Mary. Yes, he did. And he cast out seven devils that was in Mary. Can you imagine a Mary Magdalene was in that multitude hollering, Hosanna, Hosanna, blessed be the name of the Lord. For 3 days, and the disciples said, you want us to send them on their way? And Jesus said to the 5,000, sit down. And then he said, what do you got? And a little boy had a two-piece chicken dinner. Yeah, a two-piece fish dinner. And Jesus took the two pieces of fish and the five Father, bless this food. And then he began to tear off and give to his disciples. And at the end of the meal, he told his 12 disciples, go get what's left. And the Bible said, all 12 of his disciples had a basket full. Somebody, can you imagine that there were 5,000 that was in that crowd, and they seen Jesus, and they said, Hosanna, blessed be the name of the Lord. Can you begin to see that day? Can you begin to imagine? The Bible said, if the books were written, it could not contain all the miracles that Jesus did. And so there was a multitude hollering, Hosanna! His 12 disciples. Can you imagine that they was in the multitude. They've been in ministry with him for 3.5 years. And they got to see so many miracles. And they didn't have no right to be with Jesus.
My God.
Because they were unlearned men. They didn't have nothing that the world would say would impress them. Think about it. You by the world been rejected, but Jesus said, come on, follow me. Can you imagine all the disciples that were in the multitude? Because the Bible said that the Pharisees said, tell your disciples to be quiet. But I can imagine old cousin Peter said, oh, no, 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 the Lord been too good, and he was snapping off. I can see the old thief Judas, even with the purse on his side, they said, no, 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 I gotta give God some praise, because he let me hold the purse, and you know I'm a thief. Anybody in this room can say, Hosanna, Hosanna, blessed is he. That comes in the name of the Lord. Somebody said, praise God for what God has done for you. I don't need you to praise God with me, because I got my own story. Can I get a witness? I got my own encounters.
Come on now.
I love me some Jesus. Best thing that ever happened to me was when I accepted Jesus. And I knew my life would never be the same. Because when I and you are with Jesus, it don't matter what comes. He's a deliverer. He's a way maker. He's a miracle worker. He's a promise keeper. He's a light in the darkness. And I can imagine some of the rejected folks that nobody ever let them come to the party. Can I get a witness? You didn't qualify for the clickety-click club. You didn't have enough education, credentials. You didn't have enough money. But I heard that Jesus called me one day. Can I get a witness? And I had to hesitate maybe and say, wait a minute. You calling me? The one that nobody likes? The one that messed up? The one that did just what you told me not to do. The one that went where you told me not to go. And you called me anyway. I can imagine that you like me hollering, Hosanna! Blessed!
Yes, God.
Done for me. I'm so glad Jesus ain't like y'all. I got so many things I like to tell you, but you can't hurt. You can't handle it. You fired me on the spot. No, you're not my pastor. What did you say you did? No.
Before you were saved.
Before I was saved, Sister Miller, won't y'all know? See, that's the beauty of being saved. Jesus picked you up, picked me up, and he knew we were dirty. Uh-oh. He knew we were fornicators. Uh-oh. Drinkers and drunkards. Come on, somebody. He went to the jail and picked some of us up. We weren't free. We was in jail as a legal criminal, and God came to the jail. No, you messed up. No, I messed up. And he still said, come on. Somebody shout, Hosanna!
Hallelujah.
Oh, I know how long you've been saved, but tell me about what you did before you got saved.
That's right.
Oh, you got amnesia. Well, I quite can't recollect what I did. Somebody said, but the Lord.
But the Lord.
Know what we did. Come on, everybody say it. He said, come on.
He said,
come on.
Come on.
Now, church folks and preachers and religious folks will stop you at the door and tell you, no, no, you can't come in our church. Our doctrine. Our denomination. Somebody said, ease on around. I said, but Jesus said, eyes can come in. Because he shed his blood for me. Yes. And he know I don't know nothing about your church religion, but he told me that he died on a cross. Yes. And that whosoever call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. Yes. Move on out of my way. Yes. We don't be shouting up in here. We shouting today. We quiet. You ain't gonna be quiet today. Glory! Somebody said, go ahead and leave before the police come. Church folks will call the police on you if you mess up their tradition.
Have mercy.
Hallelujah.
That's what religion does. It stops praise.
Hallelujah.
And they believe that they are right because their tradition says we do not make noise up in our church.
Come on.
Don't go nowhere where you can't praise God.
Amen.
That's your first time. You get there and they're looking at you because you said amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
The whole room looks at you because you went, hallelujah.
Yeah. Well,
that's the wrong place.
Amen.
Look at this, y'all. Come on, y'all holding the service up. Look. And Marian, the prophetess, the sister of Aaron, this is Moses' brother and sister, Aaron, sisters, her sister, his sister, Marian, took a what?
Tambourine.
Who got the tambourine today? She took, y'all thought the tambourine just came into being? No. When those people came by the Red Sea, they had a tambourine. And the Bible says that Marian, the sister of Aaron, took the tambourine in her hand. What'd she do? And all the women went out after her. What they had? Tambourines. And with what? Come on, what did it say? Come on. It said, and Marian answered them, sing ye to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. The horse and the rider has he thrown into the sea. Come on, somebody. Let's go back. Because what I needed, but I ran out of time. I needed all the ladies to get up. Don't do it now. Get up. It's a tambourine. If you ain't got a tambourine, dance. Now, I found this to be true, men, that God don't do nothing on purpose. But anytime you want to get a praise party started, call for the women.
Hallelujah!
If you want to get a real praise going, call for the women. They are clapping, tambourine. exact men. Don't sit down, my time is out for that. I see it. I've been in churches where women dancing all over the place and men sitting there.
Come on now.
I want some men. Not right now.
Yeah.
I want men and new life.
Come on now, Pastor.
To join the women.
Yes.
In the dance.
Yes. Yes.
Hallelujah.
Not too proud to dance.
Yes.
Not too proud to wave our hands. Yes. Not too proud to snap off like Elder Carter. Just yes. Oh. Let's go. We got to go. Okay. And so I like this because you got to show out God. We got to show out God. The Bible said they walked over on dry land. He dried up an ocean. He's a show out God. No, no, he didn't just split the sea. He made the bottom dry up so his kids' feet did not get wet. No mud. You and I ought to shout and praise God for his goodness. He didn't just have to give you what he gave you, but he's a show out God. Somebody said, look for some show out blessings this week. Look for some show out blessings this week. Look for God to give you stuff you didn't even expect to get. Look for God to open doors that they said would not open. Look for God to shut the devil down when he said he couldn't be stopped. Somebody said, for his goodness. We gotta go. And David danced before the Lord with what? Somebody said, some men praise God. Because this is the King David. So that means when you're a bishop, you ought not stop shouting. When you're an apostle, you ought not stop shouting. When you're a prophet, you ought not stop shouting. When you're the chairman deacon, you ought not stop. Why is it in religious organizations, the higher the title, the less they praise?
Come on now.
Many of them come into the worship service after the praise service is over.
Come on.
Somebody say, but King David danced before the Lord. How much? King David danced before the Lord with all his might. And David was what? Girded with a linen. That thing. Okay. Next verse. Thank you, Lord. So David and all of the house of Israel brought up the ark of the Lord with what? And with what? A sound of a da-da-da-da. The ark represented the glory.
Yes.
Anytime God allowed the glory to be around you, you ought to be dancing.
Yeah.
There ought to be a praise party coming.
Yeah.
Somebody said, what are you doing there? Because the glory's coming.
Yeah.
Somebody said, the glory's coming.
Yeah.
The presence of the Lord.
Yeah.
Somebody say, healing is coming.
Yeah.
Miracles are coming.
Yeah.
While y'all shouting,
yeah.
Signs and wonders are coming in this place.
Yeah.
And as the ark of the Lord came into the city of David, Micah, who was that?
Saul.
Somebody said a former king, Saul's daughter. David killed Goliath and won Saul's daughter for his wife. Mm-hmm. And what? Micah's daughter looked through a window. Come on, keep me moving. And saw King David leaping and dancing before the Lord. And she what?
Despised him.
She despised him where? Somebody said, don't pay no attention to their faces because their faces don't show what's in their heart. People can smile at you and in their heart they despise you. His wife despised the king because he danced before the Lord. But come on, read a little bit more. I'll tell you what else she didn't like. And saw King David leaping and dancing. Come on. Ooh, child. And they did what? They brought in the ark of the Lord and set it in his place in the midst of the tabernacle that David had pitched for it. Come on, y'all. And David did what? He offered burnt offerings, peace offerings before the Lord. I got to put a peg in it because I want to know why when you get saved, you don't believe in tithing. When you were in the streets, you gave the devil 110%. Oh yeah, you didn't get to go to club for free. You didn't get to go to strip club for free. You didn't get free marijuana. You didn't get free liquor. Y'all ain't gonna say nothing now. Everywhere you went, you spent all your money to hang out with the devil. Come on now. But now over in the church, you got a problem with 10%. You got a problem with 10%. But when you running with the devil, you gave him all your money. All you non-tithers, just look straight ahead.
My God. Come on.
No, God ain't asking me for 10%. That's just you, Pastor Miller. And the Bible said, this is what I like. Malachi, he said, prove me now. See, I tell every non-tither, you can never say tithing don't work until you tithe. The only reason you can talk about you don't believe in tithing is because you never tithe.
Right.
And since you haven't tithe, God ain't got nothing to prove to you.
Now,
when you tithe, God said, watch and see. If I don't open the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing that you have not room enough to receive. I'm tired of church folks making God out of some kind of crook. Unfair and unrighteous. But when you were in the streets,
come on now.
All you lottery players gave your money and didn't get a dime. One person got the $1 billion, but you were in the line every day. Give me three scratch off, give me one of these. I don't know all the tick tacks and crazy of it because I've never played the lottery. But I'm a tither. And so I'm trying to make you understand that until you become a tither, you can never legally say God doesn't reward tithers. In 2023, because some people say it's over with. Well, why is it in 23 all you that tithe can say that the Lord has proved to me that tithing works? 30%, 60%, 100%. Go on out here and tell everybody, oh yeah, you know he had to get the tithing again. Because, you know, God can't get the blessing to you until you do what he says.
That's right.
So we read it.
Yes.
And it says that David, the king, Sister Miller and I tithe.
Amen. Amen.
We ain't up here, you know, talking about y'all tithe. Yes. We want the blessings.
Yes.
And the preachers, that bunch of broke preachers with holes in the bottom of their shoes.
Mm-hmm.
Old raggedy cars and old dirty suits.
Yes. Come on.
Because they won't tithe.
Come on.
They're always up begging. And as soon as David had made an end of offering burnt offerings and peace offerings, what happened? He what? He blessed the people where? In the name of the Lord of hosts. What did David do? What did the king do? And he dealt among how many of the people? Even among the whole multitude of Israel, as well to the women and the men. Somebody, everybody. Somebody say, when you rolling with the king, he bless everybody. You work with some of these cheapskate preachers and they won't give you nothing. That's why this ministry has a history that when anything go down, everybody get a blessing. When we had a church picnic, when we had the Easter, we had a Thanksgiving, whatever we doing, everybody. We don't go around and say, no, cause you didn't tithe or you owe five for the plate and you owe, no. Everybody get a blessing. That's the Bible. We got 37 years in April that God is faithful to New Life Church of Faith. that God is our source. God is our source. You're not the source. I'm not the source. God is the source. When it's God's church, God pays the bills. You better shout in this place. Oh, I know some of y'all are tight right now because you're already thinking about, I don't care what he says, I'm not going to tithe. Well, do not get in my face talking to me about why your situation is like it is.
Come on, Pastor.
Because through your tithe, that's what the Bible says, he rebukes the devil.
Woo!
He said, I rebuke the devourer. Satan come to kill. He came for your pastor. Did he come?
Yes, he did.
15 days on the ventilator, 40 days in the hospital. But Jesus stood up in the, oh my God, intensive care unit and rebuked death. He said, death, leave him alone.
Oh, yeah.
I'm a living witness. He rebuked the devourer.
Yeah.
Doctor said, we can't do nothing else for him, Miss Miller. He's got to turn on his own.
Yeah.
Woo! Somebody said, but King Jesus came in the room. Yes, he did. I had no way of knowing what was going on, what side of eternity I was in. But Jesus knew that my time was up. And he told old devil, he told old death, leave him alone.
Hey.
You got to make a few more people mad. Just a few more. Somebody say, late John Lewis, getting in good trouble. I'm getting in good trouble. I don't care. I'm getting in good trouble. Who he think he is? I'm a child of the King. Y'all are too. It's 1:30, y'all. Y'all use it all the time. Now, can y'all stand while we read this last couple real quick?
Yes.
Just we're gonna get out of here. I'm just trying to get y'all excited. You standing up? So that's one step closer. We about to go. And he dealt among the people, even among the whole multitude, Israel as well as to the women and the men. What'd he do? Come on, this is King David. And to everyone a cake of bread and a good piece of flesh and a flagon of wine. I give y'all no wine. And so all the people departed, everyone to his house. Look what this said. Then David returned to bless his household. And who was there?
Micah,
the daughter of Saul, came out to meet David and said, David's wife came out. And then what did she say? How gracious was the king of Israel today who uncovered himself? How glorious was the king of Israel today who uncovered himself today in the eyes of the handmaidens of his servant. Somebody say it wasn't just about him dancing before the Lord. All the other women was looking at him. Y'all ain't gonna say that now, women. You know it, you know it. You better sit down somewhere. You mind. You better not even smile when she comes in the room. You better not. Shake her hand. What for? And one of the vain hollows fellows shamelessly uncovered himself. Talking about King David.
Yes,
and David said unto Michael, it was before who?
Lord.
Who chose me before thy father and before all his house. I mean, David gave her right now the business. He said, wait a minute, let me tell you something. God chose me over your daddy.
Oh.
Nah, 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 nah. Now come on, let's get the last one, we gotta go.
And to appoint
me ruler over her, the people of the Lord, over Israel, therefore will I what? Will I play before the Lord? Somebody say, I don't care what you say, I know God is the one that raised me up, and I'm gonna praise him. I don't need your approval. I know it's God that brought me. Come on. I'm about done. And I will yet be more bowed. So David said, you think I did something today? You ain't seen nothing yet. I'm getting ready to go all the way off. When I think of the goodness of the Lord, huh? And he says what? More vow than dust and will be based in my own sight. Look at this, y'all. We're going to get this last one. And of the handmaids which thou hast spoken, of them shall I be had in honor. Come on. Somebody say, I wasn't dancing for them. That's what he's telling the girl. I wasn't dancing for them handmaids. I don't care if they was lusting. I'm dancing for the Lord. Therefore, Michael, the daughter of Saul, have what?
No child.
What?
No child.
What?
No child.
Until the day of her death. Tell your neighbor, you better leave folks alone who praising God. You better get out of their business when they praising God. Don't you try to make some kind of religious reason that they shouldn't praise God. Don't you try to say, my husband ain't got no business shouting. My wife ain't got no business shouting. You better leave the folks alone.
Jesus.
Y'all got y'all communion?
Yes, sir.
Reach for it. Oh, I need you to go back to that 150 Psalms, Sister Adrian. While they opening up the little communion. And he says what?
Praise
him for his what?
Mighty.
And praise him according to his excellent greatness. Mm-hmm. What did he say? Praise him with the sound of the trumpet. Praise him with the psaltery and the harp. Praise him with the timbal and dance. Praise him with the string instruments and organs. Come on, y'all. And he said, praise him upon the loud cymbals and praise him upon the high sounding cymbals. And he said, let what? Let everything that has breath do what? Praise the Lord. Praise ye the Lord.
Hallelujah. Thank you.
Shout in this place. The blessings of the Lord is here.
Yes, it is.
The blessings of the Lord is here. I can feel it in the atmosphere. The blessings of the Lord is here.
Amen.
I shout in this place. Because the blessings of the Lord, where is it at? Is here. The blessings of the Lord is here. I can hear it in the atmosphere. I can feel it.
Blessings of the Lord is here. Blessings of the Lord is here.
Okay. Oh, the blood of Jesus. Oh, the blood of Jesus. Oh, the blood of Jesus. It washes white as snow. Hey, 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 oh. The blood of Jesus. Oh, the blood of Jesus. Oh, was betrayed, he took the bread and he broke it. And he said to them also, make sure that when you do this in remembrance of me. First Corinthians said, make sure that you examine yourself, that you are a believer in Christ, that you don't do it disrespectfully. For if you do partake of it and you don't have reverence for God, I didn't say you were perfect, I'm not perfect, but I have a reverence and you should, we should have a reverence that God has gave us his very best. That it was his blood that was shed that makes it possible for all of us to be forgiven. And he said, if you take it unworthily, it'll make you sick and even some will sleep. That sleep means death. So Father, bless the bread and bless the juice and that you would sanctify it. And then, Father, you forgive us of all our sins. And even now, Lord, we thank you that even as Jesus did on that night, we do now. We take the bread, and Lord, we remember that you said, this represents your body, which is broken for you. Take it, eat. And he lifted And he said, this cup represents my blood, which is shed for you. And as often as you do this in remembrance of me. Drink ye all of it. Come on, let's just pray. Let's pray. What a privilege and an honor to partake of the Lord's Supper on today. Thank you that the rocks will not cry out for us, but we will praise you for what you've done for us. That others may not want to praise you for what you've done for them, but in this Palm Sunday, we are even in our imagination coming, hallelujah, to that moment when he rode in and the multitude began to cry out, Hosanna! Hosanna! Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. And we honor you today. Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Be seated for just another few moments. It's about 1:40, we're going to have our minister to come and to bless.